I always call you people future engineers and architects. I know you will get there. I congratulate you for your CBT. Just completed CBT. You have done well. You will improve and do better in your subsequent test, because I know very soon you'll be given another CBT. Then remember, your exam is coming, still going to be online, except the government says we should resume physically. We've looked at auxiliary view last week. Today we're looking at lying in space. What did I call it? Lying in space. Again, lying in space. The word lying, then in, then space. That's what we mean. We, in our auxiliary view, you will recall that we had it complete when we were given the plan. We asked to draw the auxiliary view. Both the cone, we looked at the prison, look at the cylinder, so many others. We took even 2 weeks to look at that, taking different examples. That's what we looked at. Lying in space is what we want to draw. We'll look at how to draw it today. We have examples too that I want to give to you today. Please focus and pay attention. Remember, you are not with me physically. These things are done by me. I'm explaining what I've drawn. So you will not see how I drew the line. I will only explain to you how I drew the line, because you're not with me physically. Your attention is important. You listening to what I am saying. That is what I mean by the attention. While watching the video, don't be distracted. In my usual tradition, I share the objectives with you now. At the end of this lesson, that you should be able to draw two lengths of lines, determine the true angle between lines in space, then draw traces vertically and horizontally, or horizontal traces of plane. These are things we want to look at. What I normally tell you is, at the end of the video, you will ask yourself question, give self-examination, have I achieved this? If there's something that is still missing along the line, you replay the video, it's for you. Play it over and over, then you get what you are looking at or looking for. That is lying in space. This is what we have for the day. There's the topic itself or the content. It is often necessary. You do not just do drawing and you do not get the true length. If the true length is not gotten, it's as if you have gotten the fake length, not the actual, the true length of the place. And then the angle too, to the plane. It could be the angle made to the horizontal plane or the angle made to the vertical plane. These things are gotten. If line makes an angle to the plane, it produces a particular angle. Then it will penetrate that plane. The place where that angle penetrates the plane is called the true traces, or the line penetrates the plane. They are called the true traces of that particular drawing. That's what we're looking at. You may not get this well until we get to know the true angle and true lines of planes. That's what we want to look at now. I will give you one example. That is, this you are saying, this picture has, this is end of vertical plane. This is what we call the vertical plane here. Then this is the horizontal plane. The true length of this object, this particular elevation, is determined down here. We'll get it why we want to produce. This is the vertical, this is the horizontal plane. They are drawn. The line SY, you are saying, this line is used to start the drawing in order to get what we want. Let us see one example. To draw the true length of a line and its true angle to the horizontal plane, when given the elevation and the plan, you should know what elevation is and you should know what plan is. Draw the given elevation AB and plan A prime B prime. That's one thing. Then you draw perpendiculars to A prime B prime at A prime and B prime. Another thing is mark A prime C, that is A prime as a point, then C is another point, equal to distance to the XY line at A. Then mark B prime D, equal to the distance from XY line at B. Then CD is the true length of the line. That is why I got a true length now. The angle between A prime, B prime, and line CD, that is A prime, B prime is a line, and line CD, the angle that is another line, CD is another line, A prime, B prime is another line. The angle between the two of them produced is the true angle to the horizontal plane. So from here we would have seen the true length, then we would have seen the true angle. That's what we call the line in space. And the true angle. Two, then let us look at the stages. This is what we have to do. True length of this particular thing, the elevation of plan given. This with the true length, this is the true length. From C to D is the true length. That is this space. Then this angle, A prime, B prime, C, D is the angle that we are looking at. This very particular angle is the true angle. These are, how do you start? Let us look at it. You draw the horizontal line. That's like SY. This one has no measurement. You determine the length on your own. You know how to do that. With the T square going straight. The next thing you do, what I have done now is, here was 1 cm, that's 10 mm. Here was 30 mm, 30 cm. To be able to get point B and C, that is to get this, to be able to get point B and A, sorry, point A and B. From here, 10 mm, from here, remember this like SY, from here to here, 30 mm. That's what I've used. After this, you get this. So you make here point A and point B to establish them. That is, you will have this, point A and point B. You join them together and make them both. You have gotten point A and B. After that, you will come down, that is below here. You get point A. I've used 3 here, I've also used 3 here to get A prime. Then here was 2 cm to get B prime. These are other places now, A prime, B prime. You have established them. Remember I said the 3 here was transferred here. This is 1, this is 2. You have your A prime and B prime. Then next thing, you join them together. You get your A prime, B prime line. You join them together. This is another line. You are determining the true length of AB. What next you do, an angle was established here, this angle of 10 degrees. Whatever you do to A prime, this is a perpendicular line. You make this angle here to draw this line down. Then you also do it to this point. The same 10 you have here, if you are using 20 here, use 20 here. Do not mistake that. Don't use 10 and use 20. If you are using 30, use 30 here. Here I use 10 as example. Then you use 10 here too, you draw. From A prime, you take a line down. From B prime, you take a line down. What you have measured here was 10 mm. You transfer it along this line. From A prime to here, you have another 10 mm. You put a dot there. That should be your point C. Then from here, you also measure the 30 that you have measured from Y to B as 30 here too. You transfer it there. That is giving you this. Here to here, A prime to C is equal to this like SY to A. Then like SY to B is equal to B prime to B. The next thing, you join CD. When you join C to D, you have gotten the line. Hope you are following now. You have gotten like CD. Remember, we got like AB first, then A prime, B prime. Now I've gotten like CD. True determination of that angle 10, or getting that angle 10 at this at point A prime and at point B prime, we then will draw perpendiculars. You now measure what you have used here. The length here was transferred here to get to point C. Then the length here was also transferred here to get your point D. You join C and D. That gives you line CD. This line CD is the true length of AB that we're talking about. Whatever you have here is equal to whatever you have here. That's the true length. Then this angle, this line A prime, B prime is coming out here. We call it extension line. When you extend it from this point to go out, and line CB, you also extend it to go out, where two of them meet gives you the true angle. That is line A prime, B prime, CD. That angle that two of them make, this line A prime, B prime is a line, CD is another line. The angle they make is the true angle we are looking for. That is what you will see here. You see where they will call this extension line. This one you are saying, A prime is going out, C prime is also extended. So when they meet here, this angle here is the true angle to the horizontal plane. Then this is the true length. For you to get this true length, you do not follow this line as bent. You take it perpendicular with your 30 degrees, 60, 30 degrees square. You know that I have that 90 point. you draw it down here. So at this point too, you also take it down. So this line you are seeing here, this line CD gives you the true length of the line that we are looking at. Then another example I want to give to you is also to determine or draw the plan of a line given the elevation and the true length. There we looked at the true length, but we are given the plan and elevation now. The plan and the true length, sorry, we are given the elevation and the true length now. We are to look for the plan. We drew the true length and we got the true angle in the first one. But now we are to look at, we are given the elevation and the true length here, but we are to draw the plan. We are given the plan there. We drew the true length. But now we have to draw the plan. That is what we, the same, almost the same procedure. Draw the given elevation AB. That's the AB like AB we've drawn before. We'll start the same way. You draw perpendiculars to AB at B. Then with center A and radius equal to the given length of line, draw arc to cut the perpendicular at C. This is another thing that this test stage, I will explain it to you. Then mark SY to B prime equal to BC. A prime, B prime is the required plan that you're asked to draw. How do we mean? This is what we're to look at. This is the elevation AB we are talking about now. AB is the elevation AB. Then we're going to get it down here. This A prime, B prime is the line we're talking about, the true plan. That's what we're looking at, the true plan here. The true length or the true plan. That's the A line. A prime, B prime. The first stage is to draw your usual line SY. You draw your line SY. After drawing this line SY, I've told you it doesn't have dimension. You do it the way you just take a length. Then you establish the point you will mark. Remember, we use 10 and 30. The same way here. You could choose convenient distance for you. Use 10 here. That is like SY to A, 10 mm. Like SY to B, 10, 30 mm. 30 here and 10 here. That's 3 and 1 cm respectively. So when you've done that, at this point B, there's another thing you will not do. Remember this point here, there's a line going up vertically. You mark 10, I will mark 10, the other example. Then that gives you a line perpendicular that will be going up here. On this perpendicular, this line I use is 8 cm, A to B. You will now use the required length as you are told in this step. To use the required length, with center A and radius equal to the given length. Say given length, that is the required length now. So you will now use, after drawing this, you will now use the required radius. After I've drawn 8, I used here to here 8, then I extended half, that is 8.5, to cut an arc like this. That gives you this arc, you are saying. The arc comes like this. Cutting this line, wherever that arc, the compass cut this line that is going up, you just mark it or note it and put a dot. Arc with given radius, that's 8.5 used here, you put a dot, note it. Then that point becomes, the procedure says to give you point C. You just put dot there, that point becomes a point C. Automatically, then you join it to A. That is what you will have. You join C to A. This one is 8, I've told you. Yours could be 10. It will be given. This is the plan. It will be given to you. Sorry, this is the elevation. You have to have the plan. So this one here, CA, is the line I've drawn here. I will come down now, like AC drawn. What I have done here, the distance from here to here will be measured with ruler. That is B to C. The distance that I have here, B to C, will be transferred from A, from SY line to this particular line that is coming down. You remember this is a perpendicular line. So the distance I have from B to C, I will transfer it to, from the SY to B prime. Then I will get the point called B prime. That is what I need to do. So what I have here from B to C, I've transferred it from SY line to here, giving me B prime. Then the next thing I need to do is to join that B prime to the beginning here. So it will give me point A prime. I'm now having A prime, B prime. This is the line I'm asked to draw. That's the plan that I'm looking for. That is A prime, B prime line drawn. That is the plan I am asked to draw. I've gotten the plan. So you see that the first one, we got the plan, we also got the true length, and we got the true angle. This one is not the plan. We are given the elevation and the true length. This is the true length. Whatever I have here is equal to whatever I have here. That is the true length of this. That is what you are given. It is given here, but when constructed here, without this, we'll not be able to get the distance from here to here. That enables to get this apron, this apron line. Remember, we're starting to pick it from here. You use your 60-30 degrees per square. With that angle 90, you project this line. That is how you get it. This line. Anyway, meet line XY is your A prime. Then you join it to the distance I measure here to give you B prime. So line A prime, B prime is the true the line we are looking for, the true plan or the line drawn. That's what we're talking about. You always hear me whenever I give you video, I tell you, use your appropriate or right instruments for the right work. This case has to do with the protractor, the compass. That is what we use to get that angle. Your set square, your T square must be very, very nice. Don't just use the motion heads, T square. I've always told you, the T square they are manipulating. You are trying to see, let me just do it like this, I can work like this. I've told you one thing, that the T-square will be the driver to you. You will not be the one determining what you are supposed to get, because you are using a manipulated T-square. It will be the T-square that will be driving you, and then you may get a result that will be bent or not really the, where you're supposed to get the true length. You may get, instead of 8.5, you may get 8. Instead of 6.5, you may get 6.6 or 6.2, because little errors will occur since your instruments were not well placed. Remember, we started here to determine, we look at the vertical plane, we looked at the horizontal plane. When you are given the plan, you have to draw the true length. I have told you, whatever you use at this side, when you are transferring it down, the same figure value, use it down. That's what we looked at the first example. We got the true length. Then where like A and B, like A, B, and then A prime, B prime met. Sorry, line C, D, A prime, B prime, where they met, the angle between them was the true angle to the horizontal plane. The last one we looked at, we're given the true length, we're given the elevation, we asked to draw the plan. We got that line. That was the plan, what you got down there. That A prime, B prime that was drawn. Remember what we got from line SY to B. Remember, it's not what we transferred this time around, but rather line B to see the distance we got. That is the second example I'm talking about. The distance we got between B and C, where we've already created our arc, and then we join it where the arc cut that line was point C. We join it to A. So B to C was the distance we transfer from line SY to now make our B prime. From there, we join it to the beginning of line A. That is giving us A prime and B prime. That is the real true plan or the line that we're asked to draw. Watch your videos. If you have questions, let us know. I've told you at the beginning, this is not where we bring instruments and we sit together. When you watch, you have any error or the problem, the difficulty, I've told you always, post a video, you can private chat me. I want to draw the get, for example, want to get like CD. How did you get like CD? Remember the first example, I used angle 10. And I also decided to use angle 10, the second example, so that I used to it. Whatever you use from the vertical line, the angle I measured was 10. Then I transferred it to the other side, don't forget. So if you use 20 here, you transfer 20 to the other side. Do not measure, remember I told you don't use 10 here, I use 20 here. You will confuse it and your work will be bent. You will have a straight work. It is what we do. As you watch your video, enjoy yourself. Have a nice day. God bless you all.